SeaWorld Day. See, this is fun. I always recommend when you're doing like a Disney vacation, Universal Orlando, things like that, leave a few days for other stuff. There's so much to do in Orlando. So yesterday we went to the Kennedy Space Center and that was awesome. And today we're spending the whole day at SeaWorld.
We are in line to go on Infinity Falls, which is kind of like Grizzly River Rapids, like a Disneyland, that kind of thing. And it's getting so hot and humid right now that even me, who usually tries to avoid getting wet, I'm like, yeah, let's just do it.
You guys can see the dark clouds are coming in and they've all already made multiple announcements that there's inclement weather coming. And they only mentioned that Atlantis, Journey to Atlantis ride, which is kind of like the log ride type thing, that might go down. But it's funny to me because like this is also a big water ride, so I'm wondering why they only mentioned that one and not like all the water rides are going to go down, because mostly they're worried about lightning. And in Florida, it's from what I learned once, I think it was on the Weather Channel, Florida has like the most lightning strikes. I don't know if it was in the country or the world, it was one or the other, but it was, that's quite a lot either way.
The tsunami hits me soon! Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
Is there a cocktail waitress up there? You usually don't like water, but it's like 155 degrees outside.
Here we go, here we go.
Oh boy, oh brother.
Part of SeaWorld is Antarctica, and they actually have penguins here, and it's really cool, and they're super duper schmooper adorable.
Journey to Atlantis ride, and it was awesome. We went around and went on again, and we got on really quickly because we bought the go to the front of the line passes, kind of like their fast pass system, and there was no wait at all. It was literally like a walk on, even though the standby line was really long, but we just went around, went on it, and it was awesome. It's actually, I gotta say, like, my favorite water ride. And that includes even Disney rides, sorry, and Universal. This is my favorite one because it has a lot of twists and turns. And I don't just mean twists and turns, but like things you don't expect. And I'm not gonna tell you what, but go on the Journey to Atlantis ride. Definitely do it, it's awesome. Even for a little one, just, I mean, as long as you can meet the height requirement. It wasn't too incredibly intense, I mean, because I'm like a major wuss. And I thought it was awesome. Absolutely. If you wanna get super wet, sit in the very, very front. Scott and Nicholas sat in the very, very front, and there was a tsunami. I was right behind them, and I got like partially wet. And it's right behind me. There it is. All right, we're on to the next ride.
We are at the Seafair Grill here at SeaWorld, and we bought the all-day dining pass, and this is the first time we're using it. So far it's a great experience because they give you wristbands, and you get to get one side or dessert, one entree and one beverage per person every, Scott, was it 90 minutes?
Mm-hmm.
Every 90 minutes.
That's a
non-alcoholic. Yeah, non-alcoholic beverage all day long. So, and we just got here, so we just grabbed our first meal of the day. And let me show you what we got.
So I grabbed, for my side, I grabbed the cheesecake, and this is fish and chips, and I have a lemonade. And one of the other sides that you can get is macaroni and cheese, which is what Nicholas grabbed. And he has a chicken sandwich, which comes with fries. And he got a bottled water for his drink. And Scott, is that a fish and chips as well?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and he grabbed the chocolate cake.
And they were ringing us up, so they ring it up like it's normal, so you see the prices. So this feast here was around $100. I mean, you would think that it would be like a gourmet meal, but it's just regular old, you know, theme park, fast food. But then she scanned my band, and the numbers went down. Then she scanned Scott and Nicholas, the numbers went down all the way to zero. So that was kind of cool. And she's like, okay, go ahead. I'm like, that's cool. Zero is my price. So far, I recommend getting this all-day dining pass.
We are here at the Orca show. We got here about 45 minutes before the show started because we wanted to get some snacks and get our seats because these shows at SeaWorld, they fill up really fast. So here's the good part. Instead of getting snacks, you know, way out there and then walking it over to the stadium, they actually have a whole snack bar with ices, hot dogs, nachos, what else? They have like all kinds of stuff, all kinds of drinks, pretzels, right at the entrance to the Orca Stadium. So you don't have to worry about it. And here is another tip. The other tip is this. We bought, when we were getting our tickets, we bought the reserved seating add-on to our tickets, which means for all the shows, this one, the Sea Lions, everything, for all of the shows, we are able to come in and sit in the reserved seating area. And let me show you where that is. So I'm going to show you my point of view of the what the show is going to be and then where these seats are because it's really totally worth it. This is my seat. So I'm basically like center. I have an excellent seat. Oh, you can see the whales back there. So I'm center, I'm right here. So when you come in to any of the entrances, there'll be all kinds of entrances, kind of like going to a baseball game, right? There's all kinds of entrances. And when you come in, keep walking until you will see a employee standing there, and he's gonna be checking your ticket to make sure that you have the reserved seating ticket. And when you do, if you guys can see, do you see how there's blue? There's blue reserved for VIP signs all over the reserved section. All the other seating that you see does not have any blue. Here is another tip. Don't wait till the last second to come to any of these shows. So this show, for example, starts at 3:30. And we got here 45 minutes ago, and that's actually exactly when they open the doors and or the gates and let everybody come and start seating. And I'm not sure if it's always 45 minutes prior. However, I think that would probably be close. I would come as soon as possible because throughout the day today, when we went by all these stadiums for all these shows, we saw signs that said, seats are full, try for the next show. Which means if you came here like for a 3:30 show, like, you know, 3:15 or 3:30 or 3:25, you're probably not gonna get in. Make it a, you know, this is gonna be our snacking and resting time, which is what we did. You know, go and grab all the snacks and drinks from the front, ices and all that, right, like I said, at the entrance to the stadium. come and get your seats and just kind of relax. It's a good time to chill and get situated until the show starts. That's definitely a tip I would highly recommend.
Well, we just got the news that the orca show is canceled due to bad weather because there's a very black cloud over us, and it's supposed to be like, I guess, lightning, and that's what they're afraid of. So I'm really, really bummed. The next show isn't until 8, so we're not sure if we're gonna be here that late. Because it's only like around 3:45 right now, so we'll see. Right now we're just gonna walk around and see if we got a deck into maybe a store or something, if it really starts pouring. And take it from there.
Here we are in Sesame Street land. So, if you have little ones, they have a great area here, Sesame Street, and there's the Cookie Monster. So I grew up watching Sesame Street, and we're talking like back in late 60s, early 70s. So I'm a big Sesame Street fan, and this is kind of cool. So it's like we're actually, you know, walking down the street of Sesame. But yeah, they look like they have really cool stuff here. They have all kinds of stores. There's a show going on over there. And look at the dark clouds. This is why everything is shut down. They basically shut down almost all the rides, especially the water rides and any of the water shows like the Orca show. There is a boys and girls room right there, and Scott just went to the little boys room. So there's a merry-go-round right there, and even that is shut down. So that kind of sucks. But there is a little arcade thing over there. And this way, I can actually smell the rain really strong. It's gonna come down any second now. Look at that sky. I'm waiting for like hardcore lightning and thunder. It just looks like it right now. It looks really, really ominous. Here is the Elmo's Choo Choo train ride. And here, so you can see the height requirements. This is for our little ones. So that's only 36 inches, so that's great. So most little ones can go on this ride. And also, as you can see, even this is shut down because of the weather. And I think this is supposed to pass quickly, because in my weather app, it says it's gonna be like some hardcore storm and then it's gonna pass. So we're all like, you know, crossing our fingers because I don't want this day to be like a wash. Pun intended, but this is cute. See, look, there's Elmo, there's this choo-choo train, and you can go around. This kind of reminds me of Knott's Berry Farm, where they have the whole Peanuts gang area, the Snoopy area. It's really cool. If Nicholas was a wee little one, which as you can see he is not, so he looks very bored, he would have loved this. All right, now he's like, please take me away. Alrighty, so we are walking, and we're talking, and we just heard some hardcore thunder, and the sky is getting blacker and blacker. So as you can see, the rides are closed down, but we're gonna walk around until it starts pouring, because then we're just gonna like run in somewhere and show you what's going on. So down this way, oh my gosh. Okay, so that's scary. So down this way, there is a little area where the kids can run around and play. Looks like it's that like cushiony AstroTurf type of thing. There's a slide and there's some tables there. And this way you can get some nice little signs made with your name on it. Yeah, these are actual food trucks, Sesame Street food trucks. I saw it on the map, so you can actually, right now it's all closed down, I think. But usually you can get food, snacks. Let's go see what they have. Yeah, right now like everything is closed. It's kind of like scary. It's like they closed everything down, even the lights are off. We're like, should we leave? Num Num menu, so they have crispy chicken tenders, turkey melt, the Hawaiian, grilled cheese chicken tenders. So they have all kinds of stuff here at the Sesame Street food trucks, and of course they have ices and all kinds of fun stuff there. And there's seating here for having snacks. You can all sit here. Very nice. So as you can see, all the families, they're all just kind of like wandering around, and we're like, we don't know what to do. They won't let us go on the shows. All the rides are closed down, and we're just kind of like waiting for this storm. I just felt a drop, and the skies are getting really nasty. Like, it almost looks like a tornado might just start. Like, it almost looks that way right over there. We make food. So here, the kids can play. Oh, look, there's Cookie Monster. That's so cool. The kids can come and play on this. That's so cool. Oh, yeah. You guys, if you have little ones, definitely come here. Look, it's like you're actually at Sesame Street.
Is Oscar the grouch for this? Go check it out. Whoa, if Oscar's here, man. Oscar was like my favorite when I was little. Is Oscar here? Do not knock on can. Oh, please be here. Is he here? Is Oscar here? I think if you push that, he might come out. Come on, Oscar. I hear him. Oh. Come on, Oscar. I heard him. He was talking. Hold on. Come on, Oscar. Get out.
I'm trying to sleep here.
Come on, Oscar. Come out and visit. I wonder if you do it enough, he's going to come open it.
No, it's shut.
Scram!
Well, that's not very nice, Oscar. Oh, yeah, you're the grouch.
Why don't you go scram to that booty truck and annoy Cookie Monster and Gonger instead, huh?
Oh, Oscar, you're cool. All right, Hooper's store. You guys all remember Hooper? Mr. Hooper. He had his little grocery store. Oh, look. Does anybody come into the window? Hi. Is anyone there? Ah! It's Elmo. Hi, Elmo. All right. Oh, that's so cool. You can come here and walk through Sesame Street, and there's all these little areas the kids can play. And oh, there's great air conditioning with the fan right here. The kids can run around right here. And I think if you knock on the doors, like the characters come out. Oh my gosh, that's adorable. I love it. Oh my gosh. Look at that. Oh, I love it.
Ring, ring. Hello.
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 Oh my gosh. Oh, this is so awesome. Where was this when I was a kid? They always had the good stuff after I grew up. One, two, three, four. Where's Grover?
What? Oh, hello!
Mr. Hooper. Oh, let's see what they got in his store. Oh, it's an actual store. Okay, cool. So Hooper's store is an actual store. You can buy like all kinds of like sandwiches and like stuff for your kitchen. Oh, the count. Scott is the count.
I get one churro. Two churros.
Snuffleupagus. I love you, Mr. Snuffleupagus. Aw, he was always so sweet. So many cool things here. So many cool things for little ones. Oh, they even have little bathing suits for little tiny boys and girls and flip-flops and stuff. That's cool. Everybody, you gotta bring your little ones here. Oh my gosh, Subway, Sesame Street Station. You can get off at the Sesame Street Station and come to Sesame Street. His name is Mr. like Guy Smiley. That's his name, Mr. Guy Smiley. All right, this is Guy Smiley. Anybody from my age knows this dude. He was the official like announcer dude on Sesame Street. I love Guy Smiley. Guy Smiley! And look, at the end of Hooper's store, Mr. Hooper's store, you can take a picture with Elmo. And whatever her name is, I'm sorry, she was past my generation and didn't exist, so I don't know. But I know Elmo, that was past my generation too, but when Nicholas was little, we had Elmo. But now that he's not a wee little one, we don't watch it anymore. Alright, so this was a very giant store. It starts from Hooper's store, Mr. Hooper, and comes all the way down, and then we exit. In the Sesame Street area, there is a baby changing room and also a quiet room. So that might be, I'm thinking, where you can go if for naps, maybe, and also maybe for like feeding, breastfeeding, things like that. I think they have stuff for everybody. Oh my gosh, look at those clouds. Whoa. Wow. Look at how bad it looks. It looks like there's like a picnic area that you can sit in. And there is a food and beverage station, but that's closed too. So and this is not normally like this. Everything is closed down because of what they think is gonna happen. I'm not sure if they think it's gonna be like a tornado or what they're thinking, but it looks like Everything is closing.
We are walking back to the front of the park now because they just made another announcement saying that all shows, all outdoor shows, all outdoor rides, all outdoor attractions are down temporarily due to inclement weather because a storm is coming. And right now we've heard a ton of thunder and we've seen a bunch of lightning. So basically we're just like walking around and we're gonna go to the shops and things like that and hope that this passes. Because they're not telling us, oh my gosh, look at that. They're not telling us that we need to leave. They're telling everyone just to hang on until they can make a decision. That looks like a funnel cloud almost forming because the clouds are going down on both sides. So that looks kind of scary. But look at that. That is super spooky. Those are the flamingo boats that you can get a boat and you can come out into the lake on your own, and that's what I really want to do. So I'm hoping all this is gonna pass because there's so many things I want to do that we are not allowed to do right now. This is Florida weather. Basically, this is common for Florida and we're from California, so this is not common for us. So I'm curious, how long does it take? Like, how long do they wait until they say, okay, park is closed, wow. Park is closed and they want everyone to leave just because it's dangerous. I'm just very curious, and I think today might be the day we might find out. It's funny because it's not even raining. So we're hearing like all kinds of really scary storm sounds, like incredibly loud thunder crackling and lightning, and we're seeing the lightning, but nothing is happening. There's not even like any severe wind really. So it's just like maybe the calm before the storm. The temperature has dropped slightly. I mean, it was super, super hot before. I think right now it almost feels like maybe low 80s, maybe even upper 70s. Like it dropped maybe a good 20 degrees.
This is just really weird. This is really weird. I've actually never experienced this in Florida. Anytime I've gone to any of the theme parks or anything, you know, I've experienced storms, but it's never happened where they said at any theme park I've been to that, okay, we're shutting everything down. Everything. This is like really weird. Okay, they had another announcement. They said all the rides and attractions, all the outdoor rides and attractions and shows are still shut down due to inclement weather. And they said, we recommend that you take advantage of our aquarium so you can go inside. Those are still open. So maybe we'll go to the shark encounter thing. That's, I think, if I remember correctly. Woo, there's thunder. It's indoors, so you can go inside and walk through the little tunnel and see the sharks, so maybe we'll give that a try. And they said, or go to our restaurants. And they actually said, please seek shelter. So I'm like, what's happening? Like, what's coming? Should I be, like, concerned? I don't know. I'm not a Floridian. I don't know. I'm a Californian.
Attention, please. Inclement weather is approaching SeaWorld, and the operation of Journey to Atlantis may be interrupted. We are monitoring the approaching storm and will advise you in any further development. Once again, inclement weather is approaching SeaWorld and the operation of Journey to Atlantis may be interrupted. Thank you.
So there you go. Well, they have made the announcement that all the rides and shows are back again. So apparently the inclement weather has passed. You can see blue skies and just a few white clouds, and all the black has passed. So. Yay! I missed the orca show, but there's another one coming up later. But right now, there's a sea lion and otter spotlight show here, which I am dying to see. And thankfully, it's open, it's running, we're going. And again, we got our reserve seating area, which is right in the center, perfect area. We got here about, the show starts at 6:30 and they let us in at 6. So about 30 minutes before, and it's filling up really fast. So I recommend getting here early.
Welcome everyone to Electric Ocean at Sea.
Linda. Crikey, there's going to be sharks. I'm going to touch one.
So, for all of you Jaws fans, Jaws 3D, which was one of the poorest of the Jaws shows, was filmed here at SeaWorld.
And you will remember the part where everybody went into this little shark encountery tunnel thing, and the shark broke through and came in.
Wait a second. We're doing the same thing.
Yeah.
It's really fun. I've always been fascinated by sharks, especially because when I was 5 years old, my parents took me to see Jaws, and that like, you know, traumatized me. But yeah, it fascinated me. So now I just love sharks. Like, Shark Week is my favorite week.
Restaurant for dinner. So, as I told you guys before, we bought that meal plan. So, for the meal plan, you get one drink, one side, which could be like a salad or a dessert, and then one entree per person every 90 minutes. So, every 90 minutes, you can do this. And we've been like adding up how much the actual like cash price would have been if we would not have gotten the meal plan, and the three of us, the meal that we're having right now was about $220. So the lunch we had before was about $100 for the three of us, and we had like, Nicholas had like a chicken sandwich with fries, I had like fish and chips, and you know, a couple desserts, and that was a lot of money. It was basic theme park food. It was just basic, cheap theme park food, $100 for all three of us, about $100. But, you know, we had the meal plan, so they just scanned our wristband, and that was that. This one is, like, a ton of food, and it's very expensive, and they just scanned the wristband, and we're good to go. So, in my opinion, I think you guys should get the dining plan. If we come back, which we'll come back eventually one day, we're going to get the dining plan. This here is totally worth it.
I had a choice of having just barbecue chicken, or just brisket, or just ribs, or you could get the sampler platter. So we all chose the sampler platters. That's a little bit of everything. And it came with these waffle fries. And for my side, I got a salad. And Scott and Nicholas got the chocolate chip cookie. And then we all got drinks. So this is a pretty good deal.
Just finished dinner and it was horrible. Seriously. Everyone thought their meal was horrible. We actually all took a few bites of everything and just threw it away. The chicken was dry. The brisket was dry. The ribs were dry, the salad was yucky, the cookie was meh. There was definitely no Jack's Num Num cookies, I'll tell you that much. Our day at SeaWorld has come to an end. We are slowly walking over to the lockers to get our stuff and head on back to Disney's boardwalk. My final thoughts on SeaWorld: the food part was not a good experience. And the food prices here are super expensive. Some of it was even more expensive than Disney. So price-wise, it was beneficial to buy the dining plan if you're gonna go to all the sit-down restaurants. However, the food at the sit-down restaurants that we went to was also meh, that I don't think we'd do that. In between the sit-down restaurants, we actually had some hot dogs and some snacks, and the hot dogs were pretty good. But I mean, so you don't need a dining plan for that if you just want to do the quick service and just grab a hot dog and a churro and things like that. But I even had the pretzel here, and the pretzel was like actually really dry and gross, so I actually tossed it. It was definitely no Disneyland pretzel or Disney World pretzel. So, you know, now as I think about it, I would not recommend getting the dining plan because the food is not worth it. Financially, it's worth it if you are going to like the food. But if you're gonna take a few bites like us and just toss it, then, you know, you're better off just grabbing hot dogs, because actually the hot dogs here were pretty good. Other than that, unfortunately, because of the storm, we didn't get to do all the things we wanted to do because they shut down the park for, you know, a few hours, and we were all just kind of wandering around. So I didn't get to see the orca show, which I really wanted to see, but we got to see the otter and the sea lion show, which was really, really fun. So, I mean, I love SeaWorld. I really do. The shows are fantastic. The rides are super fun. We all had a great time on the rides we got to go on. I love the shark experience. They have a great play area for little kids, the Sesame Street area, and a bunch of others. I highly recommend taking a day away from your Disney World or your Universal trip to come to SeaWorld. There's tons of rides and shows and everything for every member of the family, every age. The only thing we really didn't like was the food. So unfortunately, you know, that it is what it is. So you gotta kind of put up with it. I always love SeaWorld. Tons of fun. Thanks for watching Penny on the DL. Have a magical day, and don't forget to subscribe.